Hello, I'm Graham and I hope everyone's having a great day and welcome to this video. Now this video is all about this recent camera that I purchased, the Canon G7X Mark III. Now there are several reasons I wanted to buy a camera with a 1-inch sensor and a mic input. When you look around the marketplace there's really only two choices, and that's the Canon G7X Mark III or the Sony RX100 version 7. This one's just under £600, where the Canon is just over £1,200. So you're paying twice for something that's given you a little bit more enhanced face detection or autofocus detection, but you're losing it in terms of the lens. It only goes from f2.8 to f4, where this is f1.8 to 2.8. Admittedly, this is only 24 to 100 millimeters, but that's fine for me with this type of camera. I do have the Canon PowerShot SX740HS, which has got 4K video features in here, but it's on a 1/23-inch sensor, so it gives me a 40x zoom, so that's over 600 millimeters if I wanted some close-up shots, obviously with a 1/23-inch sensor, not with a 1-inch sensor that's in the G7X. Looking at all the specifications for this camera on the Canon website, I was happy to go ahead with the purchase. I didn't really look at many reviews for this camera. I just wanted to purchase it and get on and use it. And that was really a bit of a mistake. I should have looked at a lot more reviews on this camera, as I found now that the autofocus when you're in face tracking isn't really very good. There was a firmware upgrade at the end of October 2019 to allow a different autofocus mode, which is where they called responsive rather than the smooth, which is in the first version of the firmware, and that was supposed to overcome the slight hunting that you would get or flickering in the background with the face detect, but that really hasn't improved the face detection as far as I can see. When you're holding this at arm's length, even if the box is on your face and it looks as though you're in focus, when you review the footage the camera is moving in and out of focus. It's a bit of an annoying feature, and most of the shots are ruined because it's not in focus. Move away from face detect and set it to single area or multiple area. Once it locks on, it stays locked on and it's giving you great footage. And that's the reason I'll be using it, I guess, most of the time, or using it on a tripod or a handheld with it on a subject with a single area autofocus rather than face detect. It's believed that the sensor in this camera is the Sony RX100 Mark IV sensor, which is contrast based rather than the phase detect that was introduced with the version 5 of that camera. It's taken Sony up to version 7 to latch onto the fact that vloggers wanted a mic input, so they're a little bit behind the curve in terms of adding a 3.5mm socket onto their compact cameras. I guess they wanted to protect their bigger line of cameras. In terms of image quality, this camera has given me some great image quality already, and you'll see some of the pictures I've been shooting with the camera at the end of the video, along with some of the videos that I've shot. Out of the camera, the JPEGs don't need any processing whatsoever if you're using the fine detail. If you like the colours to be less saturated, you can go down to the natural or faithful photo styles and get much less saturated. If you shoot in RAW, then if you use the Canon DPP4 software that's available with this camera, you'll find you can choose your own profiles, or you can moderate the RAW file that's come out of the camera and process it just exactly as you want. You can even create your own photo styles for the types of shot that you want. So you can add saturation, remove saturation, move up the sharpness or reduce it. You've got all those parameters to play with within that software. So the DPP4 software is great if you want to modulate the way that the camera will manipulate your RAW files. For the fact that this camera has got the 3.5mm audio input was the reason I bought it. It does give me enhanced capabilities for capturing videos in 4K when I'm out and about, and I don't want to take a larger camera with me. I've got plenty of 1-inch sensor cameras from Panasonic. I've got the 1000 Mark 1 and 2, and I've got the FZ2000-2500 camera to give me 1-inch sensor quality if I want. Want to go beyond that, I've got APS-C and I've got Micro Four Thirds, so this is really just a pocketable version with a camera that's got the capability of an audio input should I want to use the Rode Video Micro or the Vocal Air system. With it coming with a vlogging kit, you get this handle which has got the removable Bluetooth remote control system, so you can actually control the start and stop of video recording, or if you're in stills mode, you can use it to fire the shutter or fire it with a 2 second delay. You can control the zoom of the lens, because it's got the power zoom obviously in the camera, so you can change the focal length of the camera from the remote control. It does give you this option of the microphone extension arm, so you can actually fit your external mic to it, so that's a great feature. Handle also allows you to turn it around, so if you wanted to change it from vlogging to forward facing, and you can just turn the screen down, flip up the camera, and then you can use it forward facing, turn the microphone around if you want to make a commentary at the same time. So this vlogging handle gives you a lot more opportunities for your creative video needs, so a great addition. So if you buy it with the camera as the vlogging kit, then you're only going to be spending £50 rather than £100 and something with a memory card. So the pluses of the camera are great image quality, great video quality, and I guess the minuses are the autofocus doesn't work with face recognition. So as a vlogging style camera, this is not going to be the camera for you. You probably have to move up to a APS-C camera like the Canon EOS M6 Mark II, which I'm using to record this now. It's obviously a heavier camera, and to get a 18mm lens, which is probably needed for vlogging rather than the 24mm lens, you're adding a little bit more weight and bulk to the camera, so it's not that easy to hold it out on your arm, even with this vlogging handle, which will work incidentally with the EOS M6 Mark II camera as well. You are otherwise needing to buy the Sony RX 100 Mark 7 if you want a camera with a mic input. So that's the choices if you want to use a 1-inch sensor compact travel zoom camera for vlogging and great videos. Well, that's it for my quick review of the camera. Initial disappointment for the fact that the autofocus didn't work for face recognition, but after that I got over that hurdle, seen the quality of the video and stills from it, I'm quite happy to keep the camera and use it for my everyday needs. So let's have a look at some of the stills and some of the video that I've shot with the camera, and you can see the quality for yourself. So that's it for the video. Thanks very much for watching. Please do take care, and I hope to see you all in future videos. Goodbye for now.